So he was a rookie last season, and this season he's only taking it to the next level. So I have taken note of that, and I've put together my own highlight package based on a combination of videos I found on YouTube. So check this out. You won't be disappointed. Start at the top, and we've got a size 52XL, which is the size I wear, which I always get in the Swingman, and authentic new Nike jerseys. So this is actually my favorite part of the jersey is the collar. You know, it makes the jersey, in my opinion. This has got the throwback design here, and this is an MEM. So all the way around, that's the design. If you go back to the Memphis Grizzlies era, this is like similar to that pattern of the Vancouver Grizzlies. I'm sorry, going back to the Vancouver Grizzlies. So they used that and then they incorporated the Memphis. I thought that was very creative. This is a Jordan brand jersey, and this is nothing on here is stitched. Okay, just like all Swingman jerseys now by new Nike. So you got the Jumpman logo here. You've got Grizzlies number 12. Everything heat pressed. Same mesh material throughout. Okay, nothing on the sleeves here. Nothing on the side panels. So it's a plain, I would call this a Carolina blue or close to it. All right. And there we go with the jock tag. Okay. And going back to this design, I did see a video about it. I know it seems very plain, but they put a lot of thought into it. There's a street in Memphis that has bars and they have signs, and you know, the font is a reference to that. You know, they have the lettering of the neon signs. Overall, you know, I would say compared to the 90s jerseys, I'm greatly disappointed with the designs of today's jerseys, but you know, they're getting a little bit better now. Even the Rev 30s were better, but you know, by the way, I got this from Hibbett Sports, and you can see a little bit of creasing in here. So I wasn't happy about that, but I think, you know, wearing it, it'll just come out. I still give the jersey 8 or 9 out of 10 in terms of the condition it arrived in. You know, it wasn't perfect, but lately I've seen Nike really mess up with that. They've, like, the NBA store will send really shitty conditioned jerseys to people. We'll take a quick look at the back. We've got the same collar on the back. Got that NBA logo, which is like rubber. You can see the mesh holes through the rubber because it's just basically glued right on there. Very, very close to the material. So it goes right through the, because it's indented. And Moret. So this is heat pressed again. No outline, just a plain. This is like a navy lettering here. Then you've got the number 12. And the light blue in here is not part of the jersey. It is the material that was heat pressed on. So it's all one strip. And it's just a plain back overall. You know, I like the jersey because of the color. And like I said, my favorite part is this right here. I didn't have any jerseys this shade of blue. So I do have these Jumpman Pro. So I kind of thought, you know, that would be a good match. So before I go, guys, I want to show you one thing here. Because it kind of concerns me. Apparently, you know, there's guys that post videos and, you know, more power to them. But I just can't understand for the life of me, you know, why my videos can get like one or two likes. And meanwhile, a guy that's posting a fake jersey can get 82 likes. And he could get 179 subscribers and 5,848 views. In my opinion, just save up. I mean, I know you'd be spending a lot more money, but to me, it's worth it. Even if the quality of the jerseys lately has been going down, I just wouldn't want to wear a fake jersey. For $15, it's not much, but it's not even worth $15 to me. You'd have to pay me to wear a fake jersey, in fact. I just wouldn't do it. You know, if some people like it, great. But, you know, I'd look at them at like, they wouldn't get any props from me for it. That being said, I guess a lot of people out there like it. And I get it. It's budget friendly. So I guess that's the main appeal. People try to justify it saying, oh, it's so close to the real thing. No, it isn't. I don't know if you're trying to convince yourself of that or you actually believe it. Maybe to like jersey heads, they have a sharper eye for it. So for them, it makes it feel a lot worse than maybe it is. But I don't think so, to be honest. If you enjoyed my video and my jersey, you know, go ahead and give me a like and a sub if you will. I'd like to think I'm producing, you know, quality content. And I hope that I am, you know, let me know. Please let me know what you think and, you know, let me know what you think about the fakes, if that's totally fine with you. I'm never going to make videos on fake jerseys, okay? But, you know, I do make swingman jerseys, replica jerseys, authentic, pro cut, game issued, game worn. All of the above are, you know, part of my collection. So I'm going to continue to make videos as long as my sanity will allow me to do so, with only getting, you know, a few subs and a few likes. Like I said, you know, in the past, I'm not trying to be the number one top guy, but I have, in my opinion, number one type guy jerseys. Not in the world, but on YouTube. So, you know, I think my collection stacks up to just about anyone. You know, there's a few guys who are right up there with me, and they probably think their collection is better, and that's cool. You know, they have a claim to that because their jerseys are expansive and they are diverse and they've been in the game for a long time. I also have a dope ass collection that I think should get a little recognition, but I enjoy also being helpful to people. So, you know, if I can make a video that prevents you from getting the wrong size or just showing you what kind of product you'll actually get, you know, answering any questions people have, and just having conversations, I'd like, you know, I'm a fanatic. That's in my name. Okay. I like discussing the guy all the way at the end of the bench, all the way to the superstars. Okay, so I'm a Heat fan. I've been following since day one. I've watched nearly every game since like 1991, something like that. And they were founded in 88. Okay, I'd say like 1990, 91 is when I started, around there. So I really only missed a couple seasons. So in any case, guys, let me know. All right, see you next time.